Hello, my friends.
Welcome to the trade district of Stormwind.
We spent almost a week in our mercenary camp, and just returned to Stormwind to share our initial impressions.
As you know, our team pays special attention to the Hearthstone economy. We carefully monitor the balance of free resources, the value of event rewards, and the total amount of players' expenses. We were eagerly awaiting the release of the mercenaries to finally find out all the hidden details of its monetization. In the next 10 minutes, you will find out why Mercenaries is the most expensive Blizzard game in history. We also collected data for you about the cost of the full collection and the unstable value of Mercenaries packs. In addition, we will answer the question, is it possible to get the entire collection of Mercenaries for free and what needs to be done for this?
The release of Mercenaries was an important update that brought Hearthstone into a new era. Hearthstone's constructed modes are now just one small part of Blizzard's card game platform. Battlegrounds was an important first step towards diversification, but unlike the Mercenaries, it doesn't have its own economy, it's almost free.
Let's be honest, in the last 2 years we have received more new features than in the first 5 years of Hearthstone's existence.
Major monthly updates for each mode keep different aspects of the game fresh, and a new progression system allows you to earn resources to expand your constructed collection in any mode. But at the same time, we are very worried about one thing. Will free two-play players be able to do well enough in several modes simultaneously? How much will premium players be forced to spend? Let's try to figure it out.
So, the economy of Mercenaries has nothing to do with the economy of traditional Hearthstone. This is a completely separate, independent game with its own ideology. Unlike traditional Hearthstone, the purchase of packs is optional in Mercenaries.
Of course, packs are the easiest way to get Mercenaries, but players can also craft Mercenaries using coins. Mercenaries have three different rarity levels. The cost of crafting mercenary cards is 100, 300 and 500 coins, depending on the rarity. This cost looks very friendly. Thus, even if you don't open any packs, you will eventually be able to craft most mercenaries after a while. Obtaining mercenaries will take time, but isn't too difficult. However, you will need significantly more effort or money to fully upgrade all of these mercenaries' abilities and equipment. To fully upgrade one ability, you need 475 coins, and another 425 coins for one piece of equipment. To upgrade all three abilities and three equipment, you need to spend 2,700 coins. You cannot refuse to improve weak equipment, since your mercenary will receive additional stats if everything is improved.
Some mercenaries have special items that don't need upgrades, which makes full improvement a little less expensive. To collect all the improved mercenaries, you need to spend over 140,000 coins.
Guys, this sounds a little scary. How many packs do I need to buy to get the entire collection?
That's a great question, Dora. Mercenaries pack can contain an average of 150 coins of various rarities, hero cards and alternative portraits. According to our preliminary calculations, you need to open approximately 17 packs to get the complete collection of rare mercenaries, 80 packs for epic ones, and 285 packs for legendary mercenaries. Unfortunately, we do not have a clear defined drop rate for portraits. You will need to open approximately 80 packs for all rare portraits, 290 for epic and about 1,000 packs for all legendary portraits. If you want to immediately get all the improved mercenaries, you need to purchase about 1,200 packs.
We want to draw your attention to a very important fact about packs. The value of Hearthstone packs is variable. The more packs you are going to open, the less benefit you get. But mercenary packs are losing value very quickly.
For example, the first 5 packs have the greatest value, as they usually contain a guaranteed legendary mercenary. The first 17 packs contain new rare characters, which makes the value of the packs quite high as well. The value of the 18th pack is significantly reduced, since after receiving all rare mercenaries, you will receive rare portraits that have no value and cannot be exchanged for mercenary coins. Thus, the value of portraits, at least from an economic point of view, is zero. After you have collected all the rare portraits, the value of packs should in theory increase again, since instead of rare portraits you will receive rare coins, but this will not happen, because in subsequent packs you will find epic portraits instead of epic heroes. Moreover, the value of packs will decrease again if you continue to open packs after receiving all the legendary heroes. After you get enough rare coins to upgrade your mercenaries, your packs will lose value again, as you will not be able to use extra coins.
This data is shocking. In other words, the economy of mercenaries is significantly worse than the economy of Hearthstone. In addition to the fact that you will have to invest significantly more, you will receive less and less rewards for your money. This is just crazy.
Mercenaries isn't just the most expensive Hearthstone mode. This is definitely the most expensive game Blizzard has ever made, yet the mode is also fairly loyal to the players, who are ready to dedicate their time to it. Let's talk about this in more detail. First, let's define the sources of resources and their value.
The first source of resources is gifts received during special events. At the moment we've received only 8 packs, 6 packs for free to celebrate the release of the new mode, plus 2 packs for watching streams on Twitch. The value of 8 packs is equivalent to almost 2,200 coins, which allows you to get about 1% of the completely improved collection. The next way to get resources is campfire tasks. You will be faced with 3 types of tasks: narrative, daily, and questlines. Narrative tasks allow you to get 12 packs and some coins of various rarities. The total reward value is equivalent to 2% of the full collection. Daily tasks will allow you to get 50 coins a day. Thus, completing daily tasks for 4 months, you can get 6,000 coins. The most important source of free resources is the mercenaries' questlines. By completing these tasks, you get access to powerful equipment and mercenary coins. In addition, for completing a line of 18 tasks, you will receive 3 packs as a reward. In total, this way you can get 153 packs as well as about 87,000 coins of various rarities. After completing all quest lines, you will receive 73% of the complete collection. If you want to receive all these rewards in 4 months, you should complete 8 quests from mercenaries every day.
Another source of coins is participation in PvP. If you win at least 3 battles every day, you can get 2 chests with coins that will bring you about 20,000 coins over 4 months. In addition, you will receive rewards for monthly ladder progress. We hope that getting 6,000 ratings every month won't be too difficult for players who only get 3 wins a day. In this case, the total value of PvP rewards will be over 28,000 coins, and about 16% of the collection.
In general, the total amount of awards for completing tasks and participating in PvP battles will be more than enough for an improved collection of rare and epic mercenaries. You should even have over 35,000 extra coins left. You will also receive 85% of the legendary collection. To complete it, you will need to find an additional 7,500 legendary coins. This means that for 4 months you have to find a little more than 60 coins in bounties every day. Finding these coins will be easy enough, especially in heroic mode, but you should focus on finding the mysterious stranger in the travel point.
Let's compare mercenaries and traditional Hearthstone in terms of economics.
To get the full collection of one standard expansion for free, you have to spend more than 6 hours daily, provided that your win rate is 50%. In mercenaries, you will need to spend at least 3 times less. But at the same time, if you want to get everything at once, you will have to spend 5 times more money.
We have mixed feelings about the new mode. I really like the gameplay. Despite its deceptive simplicity, the mode is quite complex. The game designers have done a very good job. It is also worth noting that despite the huge cost, Mercenaries is one of the fairest games with gacha mechanics. Despite this, Mercenaries looks like a very early alpha version of the game.
Don't get us wrong, we really like the new game, but we feel there are many things that need to be worked out more closely. On the one hand, Mercenaries is much more loyal than traditional Hearthstone. At the same time, it is merciless towards premium players.
Unstable pack value is a very bad thing. Despite the same cost, mercenary packs have significantly less value than traditional Hearthstone packs. The economy of the mode as a whole looks too conventional. It looks like an early concept.
Players should definitely be able to get rid of unnecessary portraits in exchange for coins. Blizzard should allow players to craft mercenaries' portraits, at least after all the abilities and equipment of the hero have been improved. Extra coins becoming useless numbers after you have completely upgraded everything for your mercenaries is a serious flaw. Team 5 stated that players will be able to use them sometime in the future.
Another drawback is the slow progress of both free-to-play players and even pre-order players. Of course, you have the opportunity to get a ton of resources in a fairly simple way, but your progress won't be immediately visible.
This approach leads to the fact that the vast majority of players have too few legendary and epic mercenaries for a variety of builds. Unfortunately, there are too few budget builds in the game. According to our community poll, only 11% of players have pre-ordered mercenaries, of which only a third have spent $100 or more on packs.
Thus, we can assume that at the moment only a very small group of players have access to all the mercenaries. In traditional Hearthstone, you can immediately create the card you want. In mercenaries, you have to wait a while to get enough coins to craft the mercenary.
All this makes creating content around mercenaries almost pointless. Why would I know about effective builds if I don't have a few important legendary or epic mercenaries in my collection?
And the last thing is the extremely poor visual appearance of the boards in PvP and PvE modes. Blizzard, are you serious?
All this makes us think that the developers did not have enough time to complete the
game. Hopefully the current appearance of mercenaries is only an alpha version. We hope that the mode will receive a host of important add-ons in the next few months.
Lastly, we can't wait to hear your impressions of the new mode. Is the economy of mercenaries fair enough? Share your opinion in the comments, and also join the vote on our community tab.
We will be extremely grateful to you for liking and subscribing to the channel, as well as for turning on all notifications using the bell icon. You can also join our squad of loyal patrons and help us create new videos.
Dear friends, from all of my robotic heart, thank you so much for any kind of support.
Alright, that's all for today. Thank you for being with us.
And special thanks to Chris for his invaluable help.
We will definitely meet in a new video. Good luck.
What?